Hello friends, welcome to the winning side, a detailed pre-match analysis that will help you to choose your best winning side. Now today I am talking about the second ODI that is going to be played between England and Australia at International Sports Stadium, Coffs Harbour. Now this is how my team looks like. Now talking about the first ODI, it was one of the toughest competition I have ever seen in women's team match specially. England had given a target of around 229 to Australian team and they made it, but very toughly. Thanks to the beautiful innings played by Blackwell, she played fantastically and given a match to Australian side and taken away the match from England side. Now talking about the analysis that we have done for this match. Coming to the wicketkeeper category, I am going with Sarah Taylor as my wicketkeeper, though Elsa Haley again a very good option. But I'm going with Sarah Taylor because of the kind of player she is, she basically opens for England team. Though in the last match, even Haley also opened for Australian side, but she didn't perform well. And comparatively, if you compare the stats of both the players, Sarah Taylor is far away from Elsa Haley. So I'm going with Sarah Taylor, but if you want, you can go with Elsa Haley too. Now talking about the batsman category, I'm going with Rachel Haynes, Alex Blackwell, Els Wiani, and Laura Winfield. Now the alternative what you have is either you can go with Nicole Bolton, again a very good player, though she didn't perform well in the last match, but yes, she is a destructive batsman for Australian side. Tammy Beaumont, again a very nice player to keep in your team, and even Fran Wilson too. But my options are for tomorrow's match is 3 batsmen from Australian side and 1 batsman from England side. Now talking about the all-rounder category, I'm going with Elsa Perry and Natalie Skewer and Heather Knight. Now Elsa Perry, I think we all know the kind of performer she is. When you're talking about the all-rounder category, she is the first name which comes in your mind, in everyone's mind, because the way she play, the way she bowl, the way she perform, she's just a best performer for Australian side. And the second all-rounder what I'm going with is Natalie Skewer, again a very good player, the player who can bat as well as ball fantastically well. And Heather Knight, the captain of England side, who didn't perform well in the last match, but yes, you never know, the best player can perform any time. Now the alternative what you can go with, either Ashley Gardner, who bowled well in the last match, taking 3 important wickets for Australian team. But I am going with this 3 option called Elsa Perry, Natalie Skewer and Heather Knight. Now coming to the bowler category, I am going with front line bowlers from England team. That is Catherine Brunt, Alex Hartley, and from Australian side, I'm going with Megan Skewt. Now, these are my options for bowling. If you want to go for any alternative, you can go with Jens Jonassen. Again, a very nice bowler, left-arm spinner. He knows how to give a proper flight to the ball. She knows very nicely how to pitch the balls and all, but she is not in my option because I'm preferring more of England's bowler instead of Australians. So, this is my team. And again, an alternative what you can go with, Laura Marsh. Again, a very good option. But I am going with 3 options called Catherine Byrne, Alex Hartley and Megan Skewt. Now talking about the captain and vice captain, I am going with Elsa Perry as my captain and Natalie Skewer as my vice captain. Though the alternative what you can go with, either Heather Knight too as a vice captain, or the way Blackwell played in the last match, again a fantastic performer from Australian side. As a captain, if you want, you can go with him, though she is a vice captain of Australian team. And as a vice captain, you can go with Sarah Taylor. But for me, my options are Elsa Perry and Natalie Skewer. So this is my team for tomorrow's match. Best of luck to you all for tomorrow's match. And please do not forget to subscribe our channel. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.